with some roses. Independent on my grown shit. Hold up, I'll bring some more wet. Just to get these bitches more wet. Devil lurking on my doorstep. Angel talking on my left side. I'm just trying to get my head right.
It's that beatbox, spit 16, let the street watch, we cross, THC fiend, I don't see cops, key flunks, whole block and get a whip, swerve when I whip, officer, I feed the fit, handcuff, once upon a time till I'm in the back to your knees, bitch, who told you to stand up, what?
Hey, and that's the whole interview, it's a wrap, folks. This is Mystery Girl, I'm here with Dylan St. John. First thing I have to ask you is, where did the name come from?
Actually, from my mother.
Okay. Oh wait, yeah, it's my that, real is name. That your real name?
I actually used to, once upon a time, you know, go by St. D.
Okay.
And then I kind of just, you know, I got it more into music, started doing this, and then everyone's like, "Yo, you have a great, like, your name is just dope."
I was like,
people say it sounds like it. I'm like, nah.
It does.
Thank my mom, you know, that's all I say.
Okay, well, that was an easy answer. I totally thought it was a stage name, so I'm like, where did the name come from? Mystery Girl has to know where the names come from. Perfect, perfect. So you were, like, born to do it then, because that's...
Named after Bob Dylan,
right,
you know?
Right, there we go.
Okay. So that's the name of my independent record label.
Okay.
Because I'm not signed, so I just created my own label.
Right.
And basically do all of move through that independently with me and my team and my manager.
Does it stand for anything?
Billboard Bound Entertainment. Right. It was like the vision I kind of had since 16, honestly, is when I created that. Actually, it was one of the first songs I wrote. It's called Billboard Bound. And that kind of just took off. I have a very strong team, you know, so I'm definitely not by myself, like ever. Like, I literally have my family. Then I have a music family.
Yeah.
You know, I have, like, people who really do a lot of hard work with me.
Right.
And that's why we're here, you know?
So I listened to the EP, Crooked Halo, but you spell it C-R-K-D.
Yep.
Is your halo crooked?
It started as kind of a joke between me and, like, one of my boys. And then the more I thought about it, I was like, wow, you're right. Like, we're all human.
We're all a little crooked,
we're all
right?
human, right? Yeah. Like, I'm not perfect.
Right.
I'm definitely far from Mr. Perfect, so... You know, and my boy's like, yeah, bro, you're like, you know, if you had a halo, it'd be crooked. I was like, oh, shit. I was like,
all the way down here.
I was like, yeah, I was like, I'm like, you know, it's not that. But I feel like the point is we all try to do our best to do good and be good people, right? But we all fall short sometimes. And, like, the whole like concept of it is we're just fucking human, you know?
I like that.
We're just human beings. We're people.
Yeah.
We make mistakes.
Yeah.
We also do great things,
yeah.
You know?
So that's life, right?
Yeah.
So it's 8 songs, and you dropped it last month. Where is it? Okay.
8 records.
Okay.
A lot of records got cut because I just kind of wanted to be like a vibe, like when you hear it almost. And it's very, I feel like, blended. Like, I blended genres, I feel like, you know what I mean?
I was going to say that. It's hip-hop. I mean, you're I would put you in the hip-hop category, but then also I was listening and I hear, like, those dancey, like, pop, electro-pop kind of, like, yeah. So I was going to ask you, like... Is that intentional? Like, why do you switch around like that?
My answer is because that's just how I create.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, I don't really put myself in a box ever. Like, I made Dreamboat, like, on, like, some, like, literally, I was living with my brother, and Sam Cooke was playing. And I was like,
Sam Cooke's got me
in, like, a mood, you know what I'm saying? And then I heard this beat, and I was like, you, and it just came. Sent it to, like, all my people that were like, that's it. And I was like, oh, wow, so I have a pop song, you know? And then it's like, I never put myself in a box, and that's why, you know, I feel like this, and you don't have to. Like, I can make a trap song and a pop song. Like, why not?
Right.
You know, it's 2017.
I know.
Like,
no,
you can do whatever you want.
You can.
You know, as long as it's just, I wanted to make sure that it's content filled, that it's not just... you know, the common stuff you hear.
Right, I mean, and you had all kinds of songs, like you had like love, songs about love, and then the, you know, you had everything. You had all the content. I think you have a song, I was gonna say you have a song about a stripper on there. Yeah. I caught that. I was like, he's talking about a stripper, right. How would you say like your creative process and your music has evolved, you know, to your new project? Like, what was your most, your past one, Momentum?
Yeah, Momentum, it like completely evolved.
Okay.
I feel like I'm at such a different point in my life, and in my career and like my just journey with everything. Momentum was more of like a vibe.
Mm-hmm.
Like Momentum, I wanted people to get in their car, like, you know, smoke, you know, maybe lay down with someone. It was my first project, so it was like, you know, it was kind of the bass, mm-hmm. and then I just realized, like, I want to get hype. I want to be like a mix of R&B meets rage. I want to be a hybrid. I want to do stuff that, like, you know, isn't being done. People might be scared to make a pop record and a trap record and drop them back to back. It keeps it just kind of just fresh for me, mm-hmm. too, you know? It's like,
something new.
Yeah, I get bored. Yeah, right. I get bored really easily. Yeah. Like, even in my own music sometimes, I'm like, mm-hmm. oh, I'm done with this
tired
song.
Hearing this.
Yeah, you know,
yeah,
but
switch it up.
So right. It's just good. I just continue creating, you know, and see what comes next.
Cool. So when did you start doing this? I mean, was this always like your career path, or were you doing other things and then you're like, fuck this, like, I'm out, I'm gonna do what I wanna do. How'd this happen?
The latter is the case. I went to Manhattan College. I was actually supposed to play baseball there.
Okay.
And then I was like, peace, I'm gonna mm-hmm. make music. And at that time, I just so happened that I met my manager, who's also my best friend since I was like 14. And he was just getting out of school and he's like, I wanna be in music. And I was like, dude, all I do is write in class. I don't know what I'm doing. I gotta get out of here. Mm-hmm. Let's go and let's take this. Okay. Met my mentor, spent 8 months at his house every single day, mm-hmm. like learning how to mix. So, you know, I do some of the mixing behind my projects as well. So, got very blessed. I got, mentored by a man named Morocco. So that's a lot of credit goes to him.
Shout out to
Morocco, Green Studios, New York City.
There we go, you gotta. So did you graduate, or were you just like, peace?
Nah,
well, how did your family take that news? We're like, what are you doing? Or they were like,
My mom has been supporting me since I was like six, writing in my like room. And mm-hmm. they were like, what is Dylan doing? Like, she's like, you know, writing.
Doing what he does.
He's supposed to make music.
Yeah.
And everyone else was a little thrown off. You know, they're like, what? You want to do what? You want to rap?
Of course.
No.
Of course.
And I was like, no, but trust me, like, we got this. Mm-hmm. And now it's like, you know, literally today, my whole family's here.
Now you're at the Meadows.
At the Meadows. My whole family's here.
Jay-Z's headlining and you're here.
Yeah, I'm just humbled. I'm grateful. So dope. Like, it's amazing. Yeah, I'm still, you know, I'm looking at the bills still, like,
right. I'm up there.
You know, it's my
flex on him real quick.
I feel like it's, you know, it's kind of my intro.
Yeah.
Which I'm excited about. And being on that stage was, it's like euphoric, you know?
Yeah, I was going to ask you what the experience is like. I mean, it's the start of your journey, right? So, like,
more prime time journey. Yeah,
so
absolutely.
How are you feeling up there? It was just
in my element, honestly.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's kind of just like game day.
Was it like an out of body experience? Do you have out of body experiences when you're performing?
Every time.
Yeah.
Really, I do. Sometimes I come off stage, I'm like, yeah, what'd you think? Cause like, what's up?
Yeah.
And then like, you know what I mean? It's just cause I like to bring a lot of energy mm-hmm. to the table. So it's almost like kind of just that euphoric feeling, especially in this setting. I'm yelling City Field, Meadows, like live stream, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
There's graphics behind me. It's just like, you know, it's really, and it's funny cause I've been here as a fan.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Saying I'm gonna be on this stage, I swear to God, like last year, I think I was at Tiller and I said to my DJ, I was like, yo,
so last year you were here and you were like, I'm gonna be up here next year.
Yeah, and it happened to be, I think, the same stage.
When you could actually
make that happen.
It was
pretty crazy. Yeah.
Oh, that's
when
so
I fell back on it, I was like, we kind of put that into fruition.
No, you speak things into existence and they happen, right?
I believe that.
Yeah, for real.
Manifest destiny.
Yeah, there we go. That's how you gotta live. Do you have any like pre or post show rituals, like anything like quirky or just doesn't have to be quirky, but anything you make sure you do before or after, like, I don't know, some people give me weird answers.
I pray.
Okay.
I make sure, like, we do a little team huddle, you know, I dedicate pretty much every show I do to Pyro, a family member that I lost, and then a friend, Gardner, that I lost.
Okay.
So, you know, I kind of just like stay doing it for them, my family, and just like, you know, I just try and keep all my team moving with humility.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And I feel like that is the key to like how we're here right now. We stay working hard, being humble, and just moving throughout the city and grinding.
It really is.
You know?
You're from New York, right?
Yes.
Okay. What part of New York?
Westchester.
Okay. So you grew up in New York. What was it like living and growing up in New York, first of all, and then making your way through New York as an artist? Would you say it's tougher?
I mean, it's more authentic. It's like, if people don't like it, they don't like it.
Right, they'll let you know.
Yeah, it's no, you don't play games.
Right.
Like, someone doesn't like your record in New York, it's like, nah.
Mm-hmm.
Nah.
Yeah.
But that's why I love it, is people come real.
You get the real feedback.
You know what
feedback.
I mean? So that real feedback only makes you better at the end mm-hmm. of the day, unless the person's opinion just is invalid or whatever. But like, people I try and surround myself with, you know, are very, I think, some of the most talented people you know what I'm saying, that I know musically, so I feel like I'm in a room with people that I can learn from. So when they give their feedback, it's like I can elevate instead of, you know.
Right.
It's like, not, it's not,
if you don't have the constructive criticism, you then you're never going to get better.
A bunch of yes men. It's just like, you know, you can't have that. They'll be like, nope, hit the note.
Right.
Like, you know, like, or you should do. And that's, you know, and that's what you need, people pushing you, and, you know, thank God for my team.
Right. What's in the future for Dylan St. John? What are you working on? Like, so do you have any shows coming up? What are you working on?
I have a bunch of shows. I got two shows in Brooklyn coming up, the 20th and the 23rd. I'm actually doing a major stage show the 20th at the Paper Box, and then I'm doing a show the 23rd, ironically, at the same venue with someone else. And then I have another album in the works. I feel like I'm not supposed to talk about it, really, though. It's called Hybrid, though. It's called Hybrid.
All
right. But right now, Crooked Halo is what everyone needs to be bumping.
So you, I got the exclusive on what it's called, right? You're not going to tell anyone else that?
I mean, you probably just did. You know what I mean? I don't know.
All right, I got the jump on it. All right. If you just found out right now you had 24 hours to live, what would you do? What would you go do, like, right now?
I would make everyone I love just come to the studio with me.
There we go. That's a good
everyone.
That's a good answer.
And make music and with all of them around me.
Yeah, it doesn't. Yeah, that was good. It wasn't the cliche like party and go bang hookers.
I mean,
and like
party in the studio, but like everyone that I love, I want with me, making, being around music, laughing. That's it.
All right. I mean, I think that's a good end note.
Hey, this is Dylan St. John with Mystery Girl Radio. Find Mystery Girl.